Hi and hello to everyone. In this video, we are going to see the amplitude and phase form of the Fourier series. In the previous lecture, which I have given in the description below, the YouTube description below, I have explained the trigonometric form of Fourier series. Now we are moving into the amplitude phase form of the Fourier series. They are nothing but different way of representing the same periodic waveform. In this form, this amplitude phase form is also called cosine form. Welcome to the lecture. Again, we are going to refresh what is a Fourier series. See, any periodic signal can be represented as infinite sum of sine and cosine functions whose frequencies are integer multiples of fundamental frequency. Right? If you take any periodic signal, that signal I am taking is x of t, which is satisfying x of t is equal to the periodic signal will be satisfying x of t be equal to x of t plus capital T. This capital T is the fundamental period. A signal is satisfying this condition along with the Dirichlet condition, then I can represent a signal x of t as a combination of infinite sum of cosine and sine function whose frequencies are integer multiples of fundamental frequency. Here the fundamental frequency I am taking as omega naught. I am representing as omega naught, capital omega naught. So it is n omega naught, where n is an integer. Okay, if you want to expand this term, I can write a naught is a DC term. A1, I am putting in place of n, I am putting 1. So a1 cos 1 omega naught t. If I put 2, since it's summation sign, so it is plus. A2 cos, in place of n, I am putting 2. Then I am putting 3, dot dot dot, it's going up to infinite. Similarly, if I expand this bn sin n omega naught t, I am going to put n values of 1, then plus n value as 2, then n value as 3, I am expanding. Okay, this is a general Fourier series called trigonometric Fourier series. This I have explained already in the lecture 10 in the last video. Okay, the link I am giving in the YouTube description below this video. Okay. Now, and we also seen that what about the even symmetry and odd symmetry. Okay, if the signal is even symmetry, what happens? That is your x of t is equal to x of minus t. So if you look at this signal, the signal which is present in the positive time is same as the signal which is present in the negative time. That is, the positive time x of t is equal to the x of minus t. Okay, so in that case, bn, we need not to find bn. So we just did that. The Fourier series gets reduced to only this a naught and an cos n omega naught t. Okay. Now, what about the odd symmetry? Odd symmetry, the signal which is present in the positive time is inverted in the negative time. So if this is signal present in the positive time, this is the signal we get inverted in the negative time. Okay. Between 0 and 1, we get this part. Between 0 and 2 minus 1, we get a negative part, negative of this. Okay. That is, x of t is equal to minus x of minus t. So signals are called odd signal. If it is an odd signal, you can just do this only bn part, bn sin n omega naught t. No need to do a naught and an. Okay. Already this has been explained in the previous video. Okay. Do watch that video. And how to remember this thing easily? See, cosine cos signal is an odd signal. Sine signal is an even signal. So if the signal is an even signal, sorry, cos signal is an even signal. Cos is an even signal. So if you like, you know, cos theta is equal to cos of minus theta. So if it's an even symmetry, we have only a naught and cos term. If it is an odd signal, sine is an odd signal. So sine theta is equal to minus sine minus theta. In that case, I have to find only the bn term. Okay, if it is an half phase symmetry, that is one half is a mirror reflection in the other half, then the signal will be having only the a naught will be definitely 0, an will have only the odd component. Okay, bn will have only the odd component. With n should be an odd number, right? Like n should be 1, 3, 5, and 7. Okay, so this is an example for odd symmetry. If you look at this part, this is a complete period, right? One half of the period, that's why it's called half wave. One half of the waveform is a mirror image of the other half. Okay, this triangle is positive, this is negative here, this is positive here. Okay, this is, if you keep a mirror here, this will be reflected here, this part will be reflected here. Similarly, this is a period of the square waveform from minus 1 to 1. So between minus 1 and 0, it is minus 2. Between 0 and 1, it is plus 2. This is also half phase symmetry. Okay, if it is half phase symmetry, the n will be, You said integer multiples of fundamental frequency. No, the integer multiples will be that integer will be an odd number. N equal to odd. A n, b n will be odd number. And if you look at this problem, we already done this in the previous video, right? I'm quickly refreshing those things again, right? So here it is, a naught is definitely zero because it's a half asymmetry. Since it is also an odd symmetry signal, okay, the signal is an odd. Right, odd symmetry means already we have seen that an is also zero. For bn, only bn will be existing only for n equal to odd. Right, complete explanation is given in the previous video. You can watch that. Our objective is to look at only the amplitude and phase form in this video. Now you'll be seeing about the what about the amplitude phase form. So this is the complete Fourier series, or called trigonometric Fourier series. In amplitude phase form of Fourier series, this is also called cosine representation. I can represent this x of t as this x of t, this capital A naught plus summation a n cos n omega naught t plus theta n. Okay, this a naught and a n are called amplitudes, theta n is called phase, right? That is why it is called amplitude and phase form. Okay, now if you expand this, you'll see the relation between the two forms of Fourier series. Now if you expand this, what happens, this is cos a plus b. Cos a plus b is cos a cos b minus sin a sin b. So it is cos a cos b minus sin a sin b. I'm expanding just in mathematical expansion, then I'm multiplying a n inside, then I am bringing the summation inside. So this is what I get. This x of t can be written as this form, right? Now if you compare this with the previous, compare this with the trigonometry form of the Fourier series, right? I will try to make it in the same screen. Yes, now it will be easier for you. Yes, okay, this a naught is this a naught, small a naught is equal to capital A naught. This small a n is equal to capital A n cos omega cos theta n. Okay, then other things are the same, cos n omega naught cos n omega naught plus summation a to a equal to 1 to n, sorry, this is n, okay, n equal to 1 to infinite, summation n equal to infinite, sin n omega naught t sin n omega naught t. So bn is equal to minus an sin theta n. Okay, so small an is equal to an cos theta n, bn is equal to minus capital an sin theta n. This is the relation between the trigonometric Fourier series and amplitude phase form of the Fourier series. So that's what I have written here, relation between a naught equal to capital an, a n is equal to a n capital a, small a n is equal to capital a n cos omega naught n, b n is equal to minus a n sin cos theta n, right? This should be a n cos theta n. Bn is equal to minus an sin theta n. Now so thing is, if you know an, capital an and theta n amplitude and phase, we can easily find a small an and this Fourier coefficients an and Fourier coefficients bn. Now we'll find out the reverse. If you know an, how to find, if you know an and bn Fourier coefficients in trigonometric form, how to find capital A n and theta n? For that, what we do is we square both the terms, A n square and B n square. Then we add those things, taking A n square outside, is cos square theta plus sin square theta. A n is equal to 1. So A n is equal to capital A n is equal to square root of Fourier coefficient A n square plus Fourier coefficient B n square. So if we already we have found out the Fourier series in trigonometric form, that is your an and bn means, so what you have to do, just you have to square the term plus just you have to square the bn square, then you take the square root, you can obtain the magnitude or the amplitude. Okay, similarly if I divide bn by an, okay, this is your bn, this is your an, if I divide an, capital an capital an gets cancelled out, so it is minus minus sin theta n divided by cos tan, sin by cos is tan theta. So bring the minus to the left side. So theta n is equal to tan inverse of minus bn by an. Okay, this you have to clearly remember that this minus is in the numerator, then only our relation will be perfect. Okay. Okay. So if you know an and bn, the Fourier coefficients in trigonometric form an and bn, you can find out the amplitude. or magnitude. This amplitude is also called magnitude. As well as if you know BN and AN, you can find out the theta N, that is the phase. That is the phase, right? So this relation is very important. So that's just nothing simple, right? If you find AN and BN, you can find capital AN, that's in magnitude. If you know BN and AN, you can find out the phase. Now generally, this is the relation actually between the between the trigonometric form and the Fourier form. So this is the trigonometric form relation, this is the Fourier form, right? They are related by the, we know this is the relation we can in complex number we'll be using between the Cartesian form and rectangular form conversion, right? In a calculator also you know polar to rectangular conversion. No, okay, rectangular is also called Cartesian form. So that is the relation between AN minus JBN. Just you take AN and you put BN, you put minus J. If you write this form, try to convert into magnitude and phase angle, you will get the polar form. This form is also called as amplitude phase form. This form, the AN and BN form of representing is called trigonometric form of Fourier series, right? Why I am stressing on this point is this minus is very important, right? Okay, AN minus JBN. This is the AN you obtain by solving the Fourier coefficient. This is the BN you obtain by solving the Fourier coefficient. Based on this relation only, we are getting this, right? That is why I insisted you put the minus in the numerator. You put it in the denominator, you have to give the phase correction. Okay. Now, we will work out one problem in this. This is the problem we worked out in the previous video. We have taken a square wave represented by f of t. Okay, so instead of f of t, I can make it like x of t. That will be better for you now, because in this problem I'm using x of t, right? Okay, the question is determine the Fourier series of the waveform and obtain the amplitude and phase spectra. That is the question, right? So what is the thing they are asking? Capital AN versus omega. Amplitude phase spectra means AN versus omega. Similarly, phase spectra means theta n versus omega. Okay, so thing is we have to find as usual a naught and an and bn. Okay, then we know the relation we have seen in the previous slide, how this an and bn are related to an, capital an, and this an and bn related to phase angle theta n. You have to watch the lecture 10, trigonometric Fourier series. Okay, this is what I have given in the below the YouTube video. There will be a description for the lecture 10 video. You can watch that video. By that you can understand how to find a naught, an and bn. Already we have derived it. A naught we obtained as 1/2, an as we obtained as 0, bn for n equal to odd numbers we got 2/n pi, for n equal to even number we got as 0. Okay, so this is the trigonometric form of the Fourier series. Here in place of a naught I substituted 1/2. Okay, I change it from n equal to an is 0, so I left it out. Bn is applicable for n equal to odd, so n equal to odd I have mentioned here. Okay, instead of n equal to 1 to infinite, simply I mentioned as n equal to odd. In place of bn I have substituted 2/n pi sine 2. What about omega naught? That's important, right? Omega naught is equal to 2 pi f. F is 1/T, so 2 pi by t. Here the time period is 0, minus 1 to 1. Okay, minus 1 to 1 means what is the total time period? It is 2. It's t equal to 2. So substitute t equal to 2, 2 figures cancel. Omega naught is equal to pi. Okay, so this is the trigonometric form of the Fourier series. Already we have derived this, right? Now our objective is to find the amplitude and phase spectra. For that, what you are doing is, so this is the amplitude phase form of the Fourier series. What is an? An is equal to square root of an square plus bn square. An is 0, bn is 2/n pi for n equal to odd. Okay, so 2/n pi whole square, square root and square will get cancelled out. So an is equal to 2/n pi, n equal to what? When n equal to even, n equal to even means an is also 0, bn is also 0. Okay, an is 0 for all values of n. Bn is 0 only for even values of n. So I put the even values of n, it is 0. So this is the amplitude or magnitude. An is the amplitude or magnitude. Next we will obtain the phase. phase. What is the phase? Theta n. Theta n is equal to. Okay, let's aggregate this. Okay, fine. Theta n is equal to tan inverse of minus tan inverse of b by n. B n by a n. For n equal to odd, what happens? N equal to odd number. Bn is equal to 2 by n pi by 0. Anything by 0 is infinite. Minus tan inverse of infinite is minus 90 degree. I am expressing 90 degree in radian way. Okay. Remember, in signals and system, we will be using mostly in radians, right? So 90 degree minus 90 degree is nothing but minus pi by 2 radians. Similarly, where n is even, Bn is 0. So 0 by an is also 0. 0 by 0 is 0. Tan inverse of 0 is 0. So minus 0 plus 0 is the same. So it is 0 radian. Okay. So we got the magnitude, we got the phase angle also, right? Now we will fit this into the expression, in the amplitude phase form expression. So this is the amplitude phase form expression, right? Okay, we'll use it here. This is amplitude phase form expression, right? What is a naught? A naught is capital A naught is equal to small a naught. So it is equal, that is also equal to 1 by 2. Capital A n is equal to that is 2 by n pi, provided n equal to odd and omega naught is equal to pi, theta n is equal to minus pi by 2. So this is the amplitude phase form of the Fourier series. But the question is, they are asking to plot the amplitude spectrum and phase spectrum. Okay, for that, what you have to do is we have to expand this term, right? If you expand this term, what happens? N equal to odd means you have to put in this expression, in this part of the expression, we have to put n equal to 1, n equal to 3, n equal to 5, n equal to 7. That is what I have done here, right? You can observe clearly. First, I have put n equal to 1 means what? 2 by 1 pi cos pi t minus pi by 2. Next, I am putting n equal to 3. So, 2 by 3 pi cos 3 pi t minus pi by 2. Next, 2 by 5 pi cos 5 pi t minus pi by 2. Okay. I got this, right? From this, what happens if you compare this with this expression? We can see this is equal to n equal to 1, this is n equal to 3, n equal to 5, n equal to 7. So yeah, this is your a naught term, this is your a naught, this is your a3, sorry, a naught is the constant, mean dc term, small a naught, this is your a naught. This is your A1. In place of 2 by n pi, if I put n equal to 1, I get A1. This is your A3 term. What about A2 and A4? They are all 0. This is your A5. This is your A7. Okay. And what about each frequency? This is omega naught. This is 3 omega naught. This is 5 omega naught. This is 7 omega naught. Omega naught is pi. So it is pi, 3 pi, 5 pi, 7 pi. Okay. Next, what about theta? Theta, this is your theta 1, theta 3, theta 5, theta 7. That's what I have written here. Right. Okay. So we have got those values. Now thing is, we can plot the amplitude spectrum. What is an amplitude spectrum? Magnitude or the amplitude versus omega. In phase spectrum is theta versus omega. Right? This is your omega axis. I have tried to write the omega in terms of multiples of fundamental frequency. So it is 0. Omega naught is a fundamental frequency. 2 omega naught, 3 omega naught, 4 omega naught, 5 omega naught, 6 omega naught, 7 omega naught. Okay, similarly, here also you can write omega naught. 2 omega naught, omega naught, 4 omega naught, 5 and 6 omega naught, right? So if this is omega, what happens here? This is fundamental frequency is pi. Okay, so pi, 2 pi, 3 pi, 4 pi, 5, 6 pi and 7 pi. Okay, at pi, what is the magnitude, fundamental frequency? It is magnitude at fundamental frequency, the magnitude is 2 pi. 2 pi is 0.69. Okay. The DC component is 1 by 2. 1 by 2. Omega naught is this 0 means DC component. So it is 0.5. At pi it is 2 pi. I mean at the omega naught or frequency pi it is 2 by pi. Okay, if you look at this, at frequency omega, omega naught or pi, the magnitude is 2 by pi. At frequency 3 pi, the magnitude is 2 by 3 pi. Just what, at magnitude is 2 by 3 pi. Okay, now it's good. Yeah. And the frequency is, omega is 5 pi, the magnitude is 2 by 5 pi. 2 by 5 pi. When the frequency is 7 pi, when the frequency is 7 pi, the magnitude is 2 by 7 pi. Okay. And remember what happens when the frequency is 2 pi, 4 pi, 6 pi, it's all 0. Only the odd components are present. Right. Next, what about the phase angle? Phase angle, when the frequency is omega, the phase angle is minus pi by 2. When the frequency is 3 pi, the phase angle is minus pi by 2. Again, it's minus pi by 2. Since negative, I have brought the phase to the downwards, right? When the frequency is 5 pi, the phase angle is minus pi by 2. When the frequency is 7 pi, the phase angle is minus pi by 2. Okay. So, this is the amplitude spectra and phase spectra. Now, the question would be, what is the speciality of this? Okay. If the square wave is given, by looking at the phase spectrum, we can easily find out which frequency component is more dominant. Okay, which frequency component is more dominant? If you observe that the fundamental frequency component is more dominant. Okay, when the frequency is increasing, the amplitude gets reduced. Right, so this sort of, this gives the frequency information. This both the amplitude and the phase spectra gives the frequency information in frequency domain. I can write it like that. Information in frequency domain. Okay, just by seeing that, I can say this waveform is having 2 by pi amplitude of fundamental frequency, 2 by 3 pi amplitude of 3 times of fundamental frequency. Okay, this can be used in filtering applications. If I want to filter any of the frequency, I can filter by designing a suitable filter. Okay, so this is the advantage of the Fourier series. Since with trigonometric Fourier series, we do not know the, we just know what are the frequencies present, right? And the magnitude a small a n and b n small b n. By going into the amplitude spectrum only, or phase spectrum, that is your amplitude and phase form only, we can identify which frequency component is more dominant. Which frequency component is more dominant? This frequency component is more dominant. Okay, higher frequencies, see, I have left out higher frequency, right? Higher frequency become, the amplitude gets reduced. Why it gets reduced? Because amplitude is 2 by n pi. 2 by n pi. When n is increasing, definitely an will get reduced. So higher frequency component are of less value. Okay, I hope you learn something useful from this lecture. In the next video, we are going to look into the exponential Fourier series. Okay, that is also a very important form of the Fourier series. Exponential Fourier series are also called as compact form Fourier series. The next video will be seeing that. I hope you learn something useful from this lecture. Do subscribe the channel. Take notes while listening the video. Any doubts or clarification, ask in the comment section. Happy learning. Jai Hind.